Hi, my name is Vivek and welcome to my YouTube channel. This is the 9th episode to create an e-commerce website using WooCommerce. In the previous episode, we saw the sale product in a carousel using Slick.js. Today, we'll work on brands using custom post type UI. First of all, let's create a new custom post type UI for brands. So, open your admin panel, go to custom post type UI and click on add or edit post types. Then fill up this information. I will call it brands. Then here I will just select title and feature image. Click on add post type. Now if you want to create a new brand, then click on add new. Then you can add the title and feature image. I'll now pause the video and add all the remaining brands. Once we finish adding all the brands, open your home template. I will then copy this hero block code and keep on modifying them. So just after the sale block, you can paste the code and you can rename it to brand block. You can change the class name to block and brand block. Then the name of our custom post type now is brands. Then I can remove rest of my code like this. And here instead of div, I want to add li. Then here I want to add a new div with a class called container and UL. And finally inside this li I want to show the image, so I will use the underscore post underscore thumbnail. Now refresh the site and you should see some brand images. Here you go. Now the final thing we have to do is to work on carousel, so we will use Slick.js. So in the new tab you can search for Slick.js and open the first link. And click on demos. Then we will use this responsive display. So you can copy all of this code and open your main.js inside asset.js and main.js. I will call it Slick.js for brands. And then the class name would be brand block and UL. Now refresh the site and you should see a nice carousel over here. Now let's remove this arrow and this dots over here. So go to the setting and to remove the arrow you have to copy this one and set it to false. Also for dots, you can set it to false because we don't need dots as well. Then I will remove one of this breakpoint, and then I will change this breakpoint from 1024 to 1000. And in this breakpoint, I want to show 4 images, and then I want to add one more breakpoint, that is 769, and here I want to show 3 images, and by default I want to show 5 images. I can remove both of them. Now refresh the site. And your carousel is looking exactly the same as in design. Great. This is the end of this session. In the next session, we'll work on footer and widgets. Feel free to comment below if you have any questions. Also, please don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel to get more tutorials in the future. Thank you.